That's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. That's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. That's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Welcome to the YCA Lantern, our weekly YouTube program presented by the Brenham Church of Christ Youth and Children's Ministry. We are so glad that you have chosen to join us in this new year of 2021. For those of you who are kids or teenagers, we hope that you will also join us on the first Sunday of each month for our in-person youth and children's church right after communion, outside or in the gym, depending on weather. We will also continue to have our live Zoom Bible classes on the other Sundays at 11 each month and on Wednesdays at 6. Please remember to click the share button and the subscribe button. Thank you for helping us reach our goal of in 2020 of 100 subscribers. Help us reach our new goal in 2021 of 150 subscribers. Now enjoy the program and remember, let your light shine.
Genesis 37:28. Then Midianite traders passed by, so the brothers pulled Joseph up and lifted him out of the pit and sold him to the Ishmaelites for 20 shekels of silver. And they took Joseph to Egypt.
Hey guys, welcome back to another Game Station. My name is Dustin, and today we're going to be learning about Genesis chapter 37, and we're going to be playing Beekeeper. Make sure you listen up. I'm going to tell you all the things you need to know to win this game. All right, so let's get into it. I always love that sound. Kind of weird, but it's satisfying. All right, what did Reuben do when he discovered Joseph gone? I think he tore his clothes. That's what people do. Like, they're like, they're like really upset, you know? They do that a lot. How old was Joseph when he brought a bad report of his brothers to his father? I think 17. He was 17. After reading the chapter, poor Joseph. In what land did Jacob dwell? Alright, in Joseph's second dream, what bowed down to him? Sun, moon. He's kind of cocky, you know. He's kind of like, oh, I'm really bigger than other people, you know. But what two things did Judah seem to be most concerned about? Your hands clean of murder and profit. Yeah, Judah was a little. I mean, a lot of the boys are something like this. We all are, right? All right, who said a wild beast has devoured him? Jacob. Oh, I guess Jacob saw, I guess they brought the robe of color to Jacob and said, a beast has devoured him. Okay, into what kind of blood was Joseph's tunic dipped? They call a young goat, you know, like a young sheep in the lamb. Kind of weird. Okay, why did Israel instruct Joseph to go to Shechem? All is well with his brothers and the flock. Okay. What did Reuben plan to do for Joseph? Yeah, he tried to rescue him and take him back to his father. What were Joseph and his brothers doing in his first dream? Shepherds, field workers. All right, why did Joseph's brothers go to Shechem? After capturing and detaining Joseph, what did the brothers do next? They asked, sat down. They weren't repentant at all at this point. They were like, oh, whatever. And we're going to celebrate. Who did the brothers see as they were eating? And if you remember, who was the brother of Ishmael? Isaac, who was the father of Ishmael, Abraham, right? And so they were kind of in the same land. For what price was Joseph sold? 20 shekels of silver. All right, what three things did Jacob do when he found out that Joseph was dead? He did all the wore his clothes, put his sackcloth on his waist, mourned his son for many days. That's what I would do if my son got lost or died. Who rebuked Joseph for the dream he had? Where did the brothers put Joseph? These brothers are crazy. Who asked Joseph, what are you seeking? All right. To whom did the Midianites sell Joseph? Potiphar, an officer of the Pharaoh and captain of the guard. That's who he worked for. What was the reaction of Joseph's brothers after he was rebuked? They hated him. Oh, they envied him. Wait, what? Oh, yeah. Well, kind of both, but really, I mean, they envied him, you know? What did his brother's sheaves do to Joseph's sheaves? They bound him. Prophetic. That'll happen. Not literally, but, you know, prophetically or metaphorically. Which brother rescued Joseph from being killed? Reuben, yes. They were gonna kill him. What did his brothers plan to do as they saw Jacob far off? That was their plan, but Reuben did. All right, Joseph's brothers asked, shall you indeed, I think, rule over us? Oh, stand over us? Or shall you indeed have position over us? No, tower over us? Reign and dominion. Those are biblical words. Shall you have reign and reign over us? Shall you have dominion over us? Yeah, the brothers really don't like them. Try to say they're higher than them or mess with them. Where did Joseph find his brothers? Shechem. Dothan. What do you know? That's where they found them. Dothan. I don't know. Which of his brothers did Joseph bring a bad report concerning? The oldest ones? No, Bilhan. Isn't that crazy? It's kind of like, those were the concubines, you know? Those were like the servants of Leah and Rachel. And so it's kind of like they were probably the least favorite among the children. Nowadays, we don't choose favorites for kids. At least most parents don't, you know? What were the Ishmaelites carrying to Egypt? All the things. Balm. Carrying all the things. All right, what special thing did Jacob make for Joseph? A tunic of many colors. right, so this is the money-winning question. Hopefully I get it right. What attitude did his brothers have concerning Joseph? They hated him and could not speak peacefully to him. They were afraid of him in his dreams. They were protective. I think they hated him and could not speak peacefully to him. They really did not like him. But yeah, so this is the story of Genesis. I love it. I love the story of Joseph. It's really amazing. But yeah, that's it for this game station. Make sure you check out the link below to play this game and get a higher score than I do. And I will see y'all next week. Bye.
The Faithful Hall of Fame, Joseph. So this is Joseph.
Hey!
You see, Joseph was the son of Israel and Rachel. Israel loved Joseph more than all 12 of his sons. In fact, he made Joseph a coat to show him how much he loved him.
Ha ha!
When Joseph's brothers saw this, they hated Joseph. One night, Joseph had a dream. When he awoke, Joseph told the dream to his brothers. He said, "Listen to this dream I had. We were gathering grain when suddenly my bundle of grain rose up and all of you bowed to me." This made his brothers hate Joseph even more. And they said, "You're gonna rule over us?" Then Joseph had another dream. And he told it to his brothers and his father. He said, "Listen, I had another dream. And this time, the sun and moon and 11 stars were bowing down to me." This time, Israel heard the dream and rebuked Joseph, saying, "Will your mother and brothers and I actually come and bow down before you?" The brothers were even more angry when they heard the second dream. Israel, however, decided to think about what Joseph was saying. One day, Joseph's brothers were working when they saw Joseph coming to meet them. One of his brothers mocked him and said, "Here comes the dreamer. Come on now, let's kill him and throw him away to be devoured by a ferocious animal. Then we'll see what comes of his dreams." One of the brothers named Reuben wanted to rescue Joseph, so he said, "Let us not take his life. Instead, throw him in the pit."
Yeah.
So when Joseph came to his brothers,
hey,
they attacked him. They took the robe their father had given Joseph. They hoisted Joseph up and threw him into the well. Then they saw a group of men from Midian coming towards them. Judah thought it would be a good idea to sell Joseph to these men. So the brothers sold Joseph to the merchants for 20 shekels. The brothers then took the coat of many colors back to their father and made him believe that Joseph had been killed. Israel wept for his son, whom he loved. Meanwhile, Joseph was taken as a slave to Egypt to work in the house of a man named Potiphar, for Joseph's story was only just beginning.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, worship his holy name.
This the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Thank you for watching this week's episode of the YCA Lantern. We hope you are encouraged and uplifted by today's program. Tune in each week as we explore the book of Genesis together. Find us on YouTube by searching for Brenham Church of Christ, and while you're there, catch old episodes or even past worship services. Help us reach our next goal of 150 subscribers by liking, subscribing, and sharing our channel with your family and friends. And remember, let your light shine in 2021.
Jesus is the light.